Welcome to One Chemistry. Always do your best. Now, let us see about 7 tricks for NEET exam. By following these tricks, you can crack the NET exam in first attempt. You should win both in practice and war. Not only the preparation, exam also important. That's why I provided 7 tricks. Stay tuned to know these tricks. Trick 1 is answer in cycle. What is mean by answer in cycle? Answer in cycle means you first start with the favorite subject, keep on answering that one, then go to your favorite subject second, then go to the favorite subject third. Normally the order will be biology, chemistry and physics. Here the important thing. First cycle you should answer the best ones and quick ones. Second cycle you should answer the doubtful one because it consumes little more time. The third cycle you should answer the hard thing and answers also time consuming. So if you answer this way, you can answer many number of questions very accurately. So answer in a cycle. Trick number 2, don't attend the big question first. The NEET question setters often give you the big question. What is the problem with big question is that it consumes lot of the time. It will also take some time to process in your mind. Here I given a physics question. You can read this one. It's very lengthy. A convex lens is put centimeter from the light source and making so on and so forth. But you have to process the data. You should know the variable. You should know the formula. Then you should know the answer. What is the problem is there is this is the time meter. So big questions are big time wasters. You should attend big questions very last. Next is you should play with your luck. It is little bit dirty one, but it will always work. Suppose the question of metal atom in the hemoglobin is asked. Choices are lithium, iron, magnesium and sodium. Let us pretend that you don't know the answer. Let us do some risk analysis here. So what we know and what we don't know, based on that we will do some risk analysis. Suppose we know the answer is B. We straight away answer it, attend it, no problem. But if you don't know the answer, what you will do? Suppose somehow you eliminated the sodium. Sodium involved in pumping, it cannot participate in the oxygen carrying process. So you are eliminated D. So answer is between A, B, C. You can choose one. But the risk here is so high, which is 75%. So you should not attend that one. Chances of success is very less. Suppose you somehow eliminated the magnesium there. Because magnesium is the carrier in the chlorophyll, not in the hemoglobin. So somehow you eliminated C and D. So you know answer is between A and B. This kind of question you should attend. Chances of success is 50%. Your luck will definitely work here. So if you don't know the question as well as the answer, you definitely don't attend it. So here you play with your luck. What is important here is if you get one correct in this way, you can answer 4 wrong. Mathematically it will increase your probability. Some people are controversial about this method, but it always works. Next trick is all of the above. Normally all of the above never be an answer. Let us see why. Suppose the question is there, who is the father of India? The choices of Nehru, Patel and Gandhi and all of the above. You can clearly say that the country cannot have 3 fathers, right? So all of the above definitely cannot be an answer. So all of the above most of the time not be an answer. Trick 5 is none of the above. Similarly like all of the above, none of the above also will not be an answer. Let us see why. The same question, Nehru, Patel and Gandhi. The none of the above cannot be the possibility. Why? Because country should have at least one father, right? So none of the above doesn't make any sense. Questioner never asks the question which nothing inside. So none of the above most of them not be an answer. Then you should use the common sense in the exam. Common sense means what? You are using your accumulated knowledge from childhood to school to college, right? You are accumulating knowledge from childhood to school. So that is called common sense. It will definitely help you to answer the exam. So let us pretend that we don't know this question. Who invented the bulb? The choices are Einstein, Edison, Nobel, and none of the above. So we eliminate it, and the above cannot be an answer, so no problem. The choice is between Einstein, Nobel. Einstein, Edison and Nobel. Einstein cannot be an answer because the bulb is the product. Einstein is the scientist. So scientist normally never works on the product there. So it cannot be an answer. Similarly, Nobel. Nobel is the guy we know. He donated a lot of money for the charity. He never works for the product like bulb. So the remaining thing is Edison. So Edison will be the correct answer here. Here we found the answer merely by common sense, merely thinking about the question. So use common sense. The last and basic thing is elimination. Everybody should know this one. Suppose the question is asked is, which one of the molecules does not exist? The molecule does not exist mean bond order is zero. So we don't know the answer here. Let us pretend that we don't know the answer there. We know that hydrogen is existing. So we can eliminate it easily. Similarly, we are inhaling the oxygen. So oxygen also exists in the air. So we eliminate it. Similarly, nitrogen. Nitrogen also exists in the air. It is also in the fixation. We also know. So nitrogen also exists. So we eliminate three answers. So remaining one definitely will be that answer. Even though we don't know the answer, we found helium by elimination technique. We eliminate hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. So use the elimination technique. That's all from me today. I hope it was very helpful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below.